That COVID not be now the excuse of killing you. It is killing you because you are not you have neglected what these instructions you have been given by health sector.
The money will support vaccine acquisition and deployment, continuity of essential services affected by the pandemic, and expand the coverage of interventions to also address the needs of host communities and refugees. The Minister for Finance, Matia Kasaija, today appended his signature on the grant financing agreements between World Bank Group and Uganda. He reaffirmed that the obligations under the grant agreement will be fulfilled and they will ensure that purchased vaccines are not wasted.
Because of our poor administration, you remember the problem we had with Kamabari, when he was complaining that we are not giving sufficient money to him to go and distribute these vaccines countrywide. Now, really, these sorts of things must not happen. It would be shame. People have fought for us. They are helping us.
Kasaija reiterated a call to the public to embrace vaccination.
Got a nice house to live, water and electricity. You dress smartly. You sleep comfortably. We die less. And I want Ugandans to live to 100 years if possible, as many as possible. Don't want to hear anybody that he has died because he has not been vaccinated.
Globally, the response to the COVID-19 pandemic has been contained through massive vaccination.
But we are extremely grateful to the World Bank for this additional financing for procurement of COVID-19 vaccines deployment and also civil works. One of the biggest challenges, Honorable Minister, that we have had is deployment of vaccines. Our population do not go to the facilities to get vaccinated. They are happier when vaccines are taken closer to them. And that is one of the reasons why we had challenges reaching out to the elderly. Now with funds for deployment, we will be able to continue with our accelerated mass vaccination campaigns that we started in October last year.
Relatedly, officials from the Ministry of Finance and some economists today held a high policy dialogue on the national budget for the financial year 2022-2023 with accord amid the economic recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic. Former Finance Minister Professor Ezra Suruma advised the government to put more emphasis on increasing production and implement new strategies for the economy to fully recover.
Coming down to the ground, knowing what's happening to each child and every citizen, and doing something to make sure that they are okay, they are in a human state, a human and acceptable state. So the economics becomes real, finance becomes real, budgeting becomes real, not abstract numbers, and they don't actually address the true condition of our people.
Paris Development Model has about 7 pillars, but for me, key among those pillars includes economic inclusion, that no person is left behind, that you are taking money down, credit to the people where production, much of our production is, that you are going to do the mindset so that our people now, you remove the dependency syndrome in our people, so that people now begin to produce. It's not government at Yambe, but what we can do for ourselves and for this country.
Report by Jaliat Namuaya for the news.